Hello! Welcome to All A Plus Essays. The best among the best. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through Pride and Prejudice Jane Austen in Letters to Alice Fay Weldon Essay. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at All A Plus Essays. The link is in the description. An examination of Jane Austen unregistered trademark S1813 social satire Pride and Prejudice, and the reading of Fay Weldon unregistered trademark S1984 epistolary text letters to Alice on first reading Jane Austen, allows understanding of Austen unregistered trademark S novel to be molded and then shifted. Pride and Prejudice is a novel of manners, focusing on marriage, pride, prejudice and social class which are projected through the characters, gentry class setting and Austen unregistered trademark S authorial comment. Austen unregistered trademark S purpose was to portray the world of the gentry class, and satirize some aspects of her society and praise others. Weldon unregistered trademark S purpose is to encourage an understanding of the value of literature for individuals and society. She models Austen unregistered trademark S writing to demonstrate her argument and in so doing she gives a heightened understanding of values in Austen unregistered trademark S context. She reviews Austen unregistered trademark S society, providing an explanation of social conventions such as marriage, social stratification and women. And Fay unregistered trademark S opinions allow readers to reshape their understanding of events and characters in Pride and Prejudice. Her conclusions allow the reader to draw connections between our contemporary society and Austen unregistered trademark S context, which then enables us to reshape our original understanding of Pride and Prejudice and our own context. Through Letters to Alice, Weldon discusses the importance and the value of literature. This is displayed through use of the imperative you must read. Her observing of literature linking to the transcendence of time is examined when adopting the metaphor of a city of invention, which educates the readers of what good literature is and the solid foundations that make it withstand time. And Fay says OE through reading literature we learn about the way people thought and how they lived, the ways we are different and the things we share. Suggesting an implicit link to Austen unregistered trademark S work. Weldon writes that good literature has the ability to OE transcend time and reach readers across centuries. She demonstrates that the characters Austen created, are still relevant in modern society. The universal themes of faults and failings such as prejudice are seen in both texts, as they were been written for moral guidance purposes. Austen uses her novel to suggest how people should behave. She condemns snobbery, pride and prejudice. For example, Austen uses the character transformation between Elizabeth and Darcy and rewards them with happiness. Through Mary, Austen uses authorial comment on pride by saying a human nature is particularly prone to it, a person may be proud without being vain. Weldon unregistered trademark S character and Fay is comparable to Jane Austen, as she teaches her niece Alice to read, be appreciative of her world and develop empathy for those who are less fortunate. Through and Fay unregistered trademark S didacticism, the readers see a changing Alice. Similarly to Elizabeth Bennet unregistered trademark S character transformation in Pride and Prejudice. Elizabeth has to overcome her initial judgments of Mr. Darcy in order to gain a heightened understanding of herself. For example, after the first brief encounter with Darcy she remains with no very cordial feelings towards him. She is left believing he is arrogant and the most disagreeable man. However, she learns from her wrongness when she begins to understand his character and his motives. This is similar to Alice unregistered trademark S experience, as she is taught to reshape her opinionated first impressions of Jane Austen and the professor's wife. Alice comes to understand, through and Fay unregistered trademark S letters, that she has taken her life and educational opportunities for granted and should not make judgments of unlovable when only based on her professor unregistered trademark S opinion. Marriage is the primary concern of Austen unregistered trademark S novel. The immense importance of which is referred to by Mrs. Bennet OE if I can but see one of my daughters happily settled at Netherfield, and all the others equally well married, I have nothing to wish for. The plot follows Mrs. Bennet unregistered trademark S desperation in having her five daughters married to men who have inherited a substantial fortune. The novel reflects Austen's unregistered trademark as context where marriage was a result of seeing profitable prospects rather than love. This is exemplified through Mrs. Bennett's unregistered trademark as comment, "Oh, a single man of a large fortune, what a fine thing for our girls." Marriage benefited the couple in both wealth and social status. Austen utilizes a variety of marriages to contrast and show preference to the uniting of Elizabeth Bennet and Mr. Darcy, who have love and respect, and have had to overcome initial personal judgments of each other. Elizabeth Bennet, who has to reassess her prejudice, and Mr. Darcy, who has to overcome his pride. They become the most affluent and respected couple in the novel. The idea of entailment ensured the family fortune was inherited by the men, which meant women had limited inheritance rights. This is the main incentive for Mrs. Bennet having her children married to men with a substantial fortune, as when Mr. Bennet dies, the family will be left poor. This is augmented through Weldon, who expresses empathy towards Mrs. Bennet, and says her life was not rosy, whether women married or not. This helps to reshape the understanding of marriage gained in Austen's unregistered trademark S novel, as it was previously believed that marriage led to a better lifestyle for women. Fay Weldon connects the idea of marriage by linking the two generations and interpreting the changing facets of matrimony. In Jane Austen's unregistered trademark S period, marriage was a necessity rather than a commodity. Alice, the representative for the contemporary context, perceives marriage as an outmoded institution. Alice views Austen's unregistered trademark S novel as obering, petty and irrelevant, as her context believes love should be factored into marriage. Fay Weldon connects the generations by justifying aspects that have remained the same or have changed. She highlights the harsh realities of married women in Jane Austen's unregistered trademark S patriarchal world. For example, she writes, "A woman could beat you if they saw it." Weldon describes Austen's unregistered trademark as contextual ideas on marriage through Anne Fay, who attempts to help her niece Alice, a rebellious university student, understand the necessity for marriage in Austen's unregistered trademark as context. She uses the metaphor, "Oh, to marry was a great prize. It was a woman unregistered trademark as aim." No wonder Mrs. Bennet, driven half mad by anxiety, knowing they would be unprovided for when her husband died. This helps the readers to reshape their understanding of Mrs. Bennet. In Pride and Prejudice, Austen satirizes and condemns her character for her obsession with finding suitable partners for her unmarried daughters. However, Aunt Fay's unregistered trademark S didactic attempt on using empathy is expressed through Mrs. Bennet, who is described as a politeness marred with desperation. Weldon details the unions between Elizabeth Bennet and Mr. Darcy to be unlikely, given their differences in social standing. This is reinforced by Anne Fay reminding Alice, "Oh, novels are illusion, not reality." This perspective on matrimony takes the reader back to Pride and Prejudice and reinforces Charlotte's unregistered trademark as pragmatic perspective, "Oh, happiness in marriage is entirely a matter of chance." Anne Fay recognizes that some unions have not changed from Austen's unregistered trademark as period. There are women who still marry for survival. For example, the importation of Asian wives links to the marriage between Charlotte and Mr. Collins, as she only found happiness, in spite of marrying for all the wrong reasons. To heighten the reader's understanding of marriage in Pride and Prejudice, she says, "Oh, the stuff of our women unregistered trademark S magazines, but it was the stuff of their life, their very existence." This is Weldon reinforcing the idea of necessity for marriage for women of Austen's unregistered trademark S context. It helps Alice to overcome her initial thoughts on marriage in Pride and Prejudice. In Pride and Prejudice, social class overrides all other emotions such as love and happiness. Mr. Darcy is the central character who defines the upper class of Regency England. Mr. Wickham uses bitter verbal irony to describe Darcy, noting, "Oh, he was to be above all company, in having been unworthy to be compared." Austen defies her conventional ideas on social stratification through the eccentric unions of matrimony between Elizabeth and Darcy or Jane and Bingley. These marriages occur, despite the authoritative Lady Catherine saying, "Oh, your alliance will be a disgrace, your name will never be mentioned by any of us." This allows the readers to see that Austen had created Elizabeth Bennet to break through her society unregistered trademark as rigid values. This is linked to Weldon unregistered trademark as comment OE Jane Austen likes to see the division between nobility and gentry broken down. As the division had been created when Elizabeth married Darcy. Fay Weldon uses social stratification to connect the gap between Austen unregistered trademark as society and the modern world. She contemporizes Austen unregistered trademark as text by having the didactic and Fay write to Alice explaining OE gentry thought well of themselves, and like to despise the nobility for their rackety ways, and were despised by them, in turn for being worthy and boring? In this, Weldon suggests that people of both societies were limited by social boundaries. Through Weldon unregistered trademark as text, and Fay attempts to make the readers feel empathy through the explanation of stratified women unregistered trademark as lies OE women were born poor, and stayed poor, and lived well only by their husband's unregistered trademark favor. Weldon unregistered trademark S use of stratification, like Austen unregistered trademark S, is used for didactic purposes. She writes all human nature does not change over the centuries. Indicating that snobbery, pride, prejudice and criticism, which Austen satirized in Pride and Prejudice, are still relevant in modern society. For example, Caroline Bingley unregistered trademark S criticism of the middle class is similar to criticism aimed at writers, deriving from the readers who do not understand the difficulty of writing well. Austen believes women should have options and opinions. Her character Elizabeth is independent, witty and judgmental. She defies social conventions and is used as a model for achieving Austen unregistered trademark S purpose, and in return, is rewarded with love. There was also the idea of accomplished women being more suitable to men. Women who were well educated in the art of music, literature and languages, were thought to be accomplished and therefore more attractive to a suitor. Miss Bingley states, "Ongoing accumulation OE a woman must have a thorough knowledge of music, singing, drawing, dancing, and the modern languages, to deserve the word." In Pride and Prejudice, the Bennet sister did not attend school and were only trained in accomplishment. This juxtaposes with Alice unregistered trademark S lifestyle, as she is eligible to attend university on a different continent to further her education. An example of this is when Anne Fay plants the idea OE don unregistered trademark T you go to UCLA and write. This helps people understand the limitations of women in Pride and Prejudice and justify the difference between the ideas of a successful woman in both contexts. Fay Weldon defines women unregistered trademark as lives in Austen unregistered trademark as context and compares it to modern society. She models Austen unregistered trademark as life for Alice to gain a heightened understanding of the difficulties women face to defy social conventions. She demonstrates this by using the metaphor OE it takes great courage to swim against the stream of communal ideas. In this, Weldon is depicting the complications for Austen to see her world and reprimand its values on marriage, social class and women, whilst providing an alternative perspective. Weldon describes the limitations for female writers as they were expected to obtender, flatter, deceive, never let anybody guess that you have a mind of your own. Female writers were discouraged from inventing and were only allowed to write about their world. And Fay unregistered trademark as brief explanation of the female writers contrasts with contemporary society, with Anne Fay being the example. With the ability of travel and freely express her opinions, she is able to write without concern of her work being unpublished because of contemporary values. Unlike Austen, she is being paid and recognized for the texts she writes. Fay Weldon uses didacticism to develop an empathetic link to women in Austen unregistered trademark S context by detailing to Alice OB your standards it was a horrible time to live. For example, she gives statistical evidence of childbirth or hillbirth was primitive there was no analgesics your chances of dying were 1 in 2. In this, Anne Fay highlights that Alice should not take being autonomous for granted. This is delineated through Anne Fay expressing OE you do not know little Alice. How recent or lucky you are? A close study of Jane Austen unregistered trademark S 1813 social satire Pride and Prejudice and the 1984 epistolary text Letters to Alice on First Reading Jane Austen by Fay Weldon, allows us to draw connections between the two texts and for our original understanding of Austen unregistered trademark S text to be shaped and shifted. Austen uses the main themes in Pride and Prejudice, such as marriage, social class in pride, to express her approval or disapproval of her society's unregistered trademark attitudes. Weldon unregistered trademark as text is used for didactic purposes to encourage an understanding of the value of literature, for which she uses Austen unregistered trademark as writing to project her ideas. She reviews Austen unregistered trademark as context by providing an explanation of social conventions such as marriage, social stratification and women. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about Pride and Prejudice, Jane Austen, and Letters to Alice Fay Weldon essay as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at All A Plus Essays for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.